Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's go back to school with your Mac. So a Mac is a great tool for any student, in addition to the obvious stuff, like surfing the internet, word processing, and using educational apps. There's a whole bunch of stuff on your Mac that you may not think about can help you if you're an elementary school student or even a college student. Let's start by looking at the dictionary app. In addition to the general dictionary function where you can look up a word, you also have the ability to use a thesaurus, which is useful for writing. Now the great thing about the dictionary app is not only is it a dictionary and thesaurus, but it also is a great browser for Wikipedia. So if you want to find out something about anything, you can just search for it here and it will load up the Wikipedia page complete with links that you can jump to inside. So it's kind of like a web browser for Wikipedia. And Wikipedia, while not a perfect encyclopedia, is probably the best thing out there. Probably a little more comprehensive than anything that you could buy. And it's free and detailed and, of course, tons of media and cross-references. So as a student resource, it's fantastic. Now, if you need math help, there are a couple apps that are already on your Mac. One is called Grapher and allows you to graph 2D and 3D equations, do all sorts of different things with lots of functions and the ability to alter things. Check this out. I talk about it a lot in episode 704. Also, of course, you've got the calculator app. Now, big deal. It's a very simple calculator app, but you can actually change it to be a scientific calculator, which is much more useful in different situations. And in addition to that, you can even go to a programmer calculator as well. And there are a lot of different things that you can do. For instance, you can do currency conversions. You can convert units, so you can miles to kilometers, for instance, or even things like days to seconds. So it's very useful for students here as well. Now, perhaps the ultimate educational tool that's built into your Mac is iTunes U, which is built into iTunes. So run iTunes, go to iTunes U, and this provides a ton of different courses in all sorts of different formats for you to explore. And it's particularly useful if you want help in a specific subject. Like, for instance, if you need help in algebra, you find that there's a ton of different things listed. You'll get results for apps for iPhone and iPad, of course, but then if you scroll down, you'll also see iTunes U, and you can go and see all for that. And you can see that there are a ton of courses here by a ton of different schools and organizations. And you can search for very specific things as well as just something general like algebra. And then see, and in this case these are videos, see video explanations of that particular subject. So if you're having trouble, maybe you don't understand your teacher or instructor on a particular subject, whether it's really basic elementary school stuff all the way through high school and college, chances are you can find one or many more different lectures, video lectures, sometimes audio, and you can try to see if that can help you as well. It's almost infinite resource for students, and it's all free and built into iTunes. Now for geography, you can't beat Google Earth. Now Google Earth doesn't come with your Mac, but it's a simple, quick, free download. Just search for Google Earth, and you can then explore the globe, and it's very useful for learning geography. You can, for instance, if you're learning about countries in Europe, you can zoom in here and see all the borders, and you can turn on and off various different things, boundaries, places, etc. You can even get information about those places here. Sometimes there's links to Wikipedia or galleries of pictures, things like that for the places you're looking at. And you can customize it. There's just a ton of things you can do to customize what you see on the map. Another thing you might be doing in school is being a member of the chess club, or in college just playing chess with friends. And you can better your game by using the chess app in your Mac. You can play against the computer, you can set difficulty level, and practice as much as you want and prepare for matches against real people. So when you're having trouble with a particular subject or just want to go deeper than your classroom materials, you of course can search the internet, search Wikipedia. You can look in iTunes U, and also don't forget to search the Mac App Store to see if there's an app that relates to that subject. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.